A 26-year-old black man is shot and killed by a police officer in Dallas, Texas. Now, what makes the story unique is that the guy was not under arrest. He was not under investigation. He was not suspected of any crime. He was shot and killed in his own apartment by a police officer who wasn't even on duty. This police officer is a white female. She's with the Dallas Police Department, and she entered his apartment thinking it was her apartment. She thought he was an intruder, I guess, allegedly. She shot this guy and killed him. She shot him. She called 911 to ask for help. Other police officers showed up. They took him to the hospital where he was pronounced dead. Apparently, she was coming home from a shift and she thought she was in her own apartment, which, the whole story seems shady to me. They put her on administrative leave, paid leave, which is typical when an officer is involved in a shooting, but she wasn't even on duty. And this situation just seems really bizarre. I understand the need to put somebody on paid leave because if it's a justified shooting, the officer shouldn't be punished by losing their pay. But I do think that if it's an unjustified shooting and they were involved in illegal behavior and they did an illegal act, then they shouldn't get that money. But anyway, and they should be prosecuted like anybody else who commits a crime, anybody else who commits a first degree, second degree murder, or whatever, manslaughter, whatever. In this situation, she wasn't even on duty. She's a white female, and they're talking about how he's a black female and he's a black male. It's so bizarre because it just, how do you walk into somebody else's apartment and think it's your apartment? First of all, how does that even work out? First of all, was her door unlocked? Was the door unlocked? I mean, do you leave your door unlocked? I know I don't. Some people still do that, and I warn people, don't ever leave your door unlocked. I told one person recently, well, anyway, I'm not gonna get into that. People will come into your house and harm you, but anyway. Why would she enter this apartment with it knowing that it's unlocked? I mean, does she leave her apartment unlocked? It doesn't make any sense. Who the hell does that? Especially in the metropolitan area, how many people in Dallas leave your doors unlocked? Maybe Dallas is a much safer place than I thought. I'm not saying it's a dangerous place, but I don't care where the hell I am. Big city, small town, I always lock my door. Always. Why did she walk into this apartment and she didn't even know it was her apartment? Like, how do you walk into somebody else's apartment and not know it's your? She must have been really, really tired, huh? And then she didn't notice that nothing in that place looked like her place. There's something to this. I'm waiting on a link between her and this guy. Because it doesn't make any sense. Was she that afraid of the guy and she just freaked out and shot the guy? Is she going to try to claim that there's some type of argument involved? I read that they actually conducted a drug test and an alcohol test on this woman. But in the article, they didn't really describe what happened as far as the drug test. Obviously, you can take it to the lab, but a lot of times you can do it like instant drug tests. You had like a 8, 12 panel drug test where you can test for oxy and test for various opioids and hydrocodone, oxy, that type of thing. Obviously, meth. And amphetamines, stuff like that, Xanax, you can test for that pretty quickly without the lab. So you can have an immediate test and then you can send that urine sample off to the lab. So you can sort of figure out pretty quickly. What about the alcohol? Was there any alcohol in your system? Because there's either, this doesn't make any sense. And, she's been placed on administrative leave and she's gonna. So how do they. I don't think there's gonna anything is gonna I don't think there's gonna be any charges against her. I really don't. Which is ridiculous because if I did something like that, we would be talking about the death penalty. You kidding me? If he walked into her apartment and shot her and just said, "Oh, I thought I was in my apartment," it wouldn't be no paid leave. This guy, by the way, he's not a thug, and that seems to be the thing. A lot of these black males who are victims of this type of thing. A lot of them are thugs. A lot of them are doing some shady stuff. But this guy, you're talking about he's a churchgoer and he's in a choir or whatever, and he's an accountant and he's a insurance risk management type of guy. Just some professional guy with he went to school, got a bachelor's degree in accounting or whatever. I'm not hearing anything about how this guy's involved in criminal activity. He was just some guy at home minding his own damn business. Somebody came in and shot and killed him. I mean. People aren't, we're not even safe in our own freaking houses. But I think there's more to this story. What do you think is going on here? You think they knew each other? I don't know. And why didn't he lock his door? You know, I'm not blaming him. I'm just saying, hey, lock your door, people. I mean, you never know who's gonna come in and just shoot you and kill you. And by the way, I have heard of some stories even around here, even in small towns. It doesn't matter if you're in a big city or a small town. Even in small towns, they've known to come into people's houses when their doors are unlocked for whatever reason, and people have been attacked. You don't have to be in a big city. It can happen anywhere. So I guess this should be a lesson for all of us. Keep our doors locked. It's not going to protect you. The idea behind having your door locked is to give having a good deadbolt on your door is to give yourself enough time to respond to a home invasion, to somebody trying to harm you. Hopefully, it's not going to be the cop next door coming in and shitting you. that's my advice for everybody. Period. So, anyway, guys, share your thoughts on this story. What do you think else is going on here? And what do you think should happen to this officer? Usually, I say, hey, let's wait till there's more information out, but I don't see how this could be possibly justified. I just don't see it. You know? When is she? Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.